The chosen of Andraste. A blessed hero sent to save us all.
I didn't ask for this, but someone has to find a way to seal this breach.
Spoken nobly indeed. You think I'm mocking you? This age has made people cynical. I've journeyed deep into the Fade in ancient ruins and battlefields to see the dreams of lost civilizations. I've watched as hosts of spirits clash to reenact the bloody past in ancient wars both famous and forgotten. Every great war has its heroes. I'm just curious what kind you'll be.
What do you mean, ruins and battlefields?
Any building strong enough to withstand the rigors of time has a history. Every battlefield is steeped in death. Both attract spirits. They press against the veil, weakening the barrier between our worlds. When I dream in such places, I go deep into the Fade. I can find memories no other living being has ever seen.
I've never heard of anyone going so far into the Fade. That's extraordinary.
Thank you. It's not a common field of study, for obvious reasons. Not so flashy as throwing fire or lightning. The thrill of finding remnants of a thousand-year-old dream? I would not trade it for anything. I will stay there. At least until the breach has been closed.
Was that in doubt?
I am an apostate surrounded by Chantry forces in the middle of a mage rebellion. Cassandra has been accommodating, but you understand my caution.
Cassandra trusts you. She won't let anyone put you into a circle against your will.
Thank you. I appreciate the thought. But now let us hope either the mages or the Templars have the power to seal the breach.
The Conclave was our best chance for peace.
That's why.
The Divine, the Mages, the Templars, everyone ready to
fix the door just like you asked, Flitter.
Nightingale's eyes, secret lives in the room. Raise tears they cry, but all the world is so
alive.
What can you tell me about this area?
Adarnus Haven's apothecary. He's been making potions and tending to the wounded as best he can. Harris is the Inquisition smith. Whatever he can make you, Thren the quartermaster can probably find. And for anything fancier, you can try buying from Segrit. His prices aren't too high. Yet. Oh, there's also my knave. She studies beasts and things, as I understand.
Farewell.
Goodbye.
Someone to speak and set us all free.
officers. Think of nothing.
got the door again, Flissa. Maybe just for a bit.
Does it trouble you?
I just wish I knew what it was, or how I got it.
We will find out. What's important is that your mark is now stable, as is the breach. You've given us time, and Solas believes a second attempt might succeed, provided the mark has more power. The same level of power used to open the breach in the first place. That is not easy to come by.
Clearly, you have something in mind.
We do. You've met Commander Cullen, leader of the Inquisition's forces.
It was only for a moment on the field. I'm pleased you survived.
This is Lady Josephine Montelier, our ambassador and chief diplomat.
You're even taller than I'd heard.
And of course you know Sister Liliana.
My position here involves a degree of...
She is our spymaster.
Yes, tactfully put, Cassandra.
Pleased to meet you all.
I mentioned that your mark needs more power to close the breach for good.
Which means we must approach the rebel mages for help.
And I still disagree. The Templars could serve just as well.
We need power, Commander. Enough magic poured into that mark.
Might destroy us all. Templars could suppress the breach, weaken it, so...
Pure speculation.
I was a Templar. I know what they're capable of.
Unfortunately, neither group will even speak to us yet. The Chantry has denounced the Inquisition, and you specifically.
They still think I'm guilty.
That is not the entirety of it any longer. Some are calling you, a Gunari, the Herald of Andraste. That frightens the Chantry. The remaining clerics have declared it blasphemy, and we heretics for harboring you.
Chancellor Roderick's doing, no doubt.
It limits our options. Approaching the mages or Templars for help is currently out of the question.
Just how am I the Herald of Andraste?
People saw what you did at the temple, how you stopped the breach from growing. They have also heard about the woman seen in the rift when we first found you. They believe that was Andraste.
Even if we tried to stop that view from spreading...
Which we have not.
The point is, everyone is talking about you.
That's quite the title, isn't it? How do you feel about that?
I don't mind it at all.
People are desperate for a sign of hope. For some, you're that sign. And to others, a symbol of everything that's gone wrong.
Will the Chantry attack us?
With what? They have only words at their disposal.
And yet, they may bury us with them. There is something you can do. A Chantry cleric by the name of Mother Giselle has asked to speak to you. She is not far, and knows those involved far better than I. Her assistance could be invaluable.
Wow. Why would someone from the Chantry help a declared heretic?
I understand she's a reasonable thought. Perhaps she does not agree with her sisters. You will find Mother Giselle tending to the wounded in the hinterlands near Redcliffe.
Look for other opportunities to expand the Inquisition's influence while you're there.
We need agents to extend our reach beyond this valley, and you're better suited than anyone to recruit them.
In the meantime, let's think of other options. I won't leave this all to the Herald.
What have your ears heard, Leliana? Anything new we don't already know about?
No, nothing. Herald of Andraste. I've heard the stories. Everyone has. We know what you did at the Breach. They might not know much about the Canari, but you'll get no back talk from anyone here. That's a promise. Inquisition Scout Harding, at your service. All of us here, will do whatever we can to help.
Harding, huh? Ever been to Kirkwall's Hightown?
I can't say I have. Why?
You'd be Harding and I... No, never mind.
Ugh.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
We should get to business. The situation's pretty dire. We came to secure horses from Redcliffe's old horsemaster. I grew up here, and people always said that Dennett's herds were the strongest and the fastest this side of the Frostbacks. But with the Mage Templar fighting getting worse, we couldn't get to Dennett. Maker only knows if he's even still alive. Mother Giselle's at the crossroads helping refugees and the wounded. Our latest reports say that the war's spread there, too. Corporal Vale and our men are doing what they can to help protect the people, but they won't be able to hold out very long. You best get going. No time to lose.
I've news, sir.
What is it?
You may want to look into this.
Nothing to report, sir.
Watch your step. Mother Giselle ought to be around here somewhere. Interesting reading. Could be worth a look.
Inquisition forces. They're trying to protect the refugees.
Looks like they could use a hand.
Oh, we are not apostates.
I do not think they care, Seeker. We are not Templars. We mean you no harm.
Doesn't look like they're listening.
Coming our way.
There are mages here who can heal your wounds. Lie still.
Don't touch me, Mother. Their magic is...
Turn to noble purpose. Their magic is surely no more evil than your blade.
What?
Hush, dear boy. Allow them to ease your suffering.
Mother Giselle?
I am. And you must be the one they are calling the Herald of Andraste.
I'm told you asked for me.
I know of the Chantry's denouncement, and I am familiar with those behind it. I won't lie to you. Some of them are grandstanding, hoping to increase their chances of becoming the new divine. Some are simply terrified. So many good people, senselessly taken from us.
What happened was horrible.
Fear makes us desperate, but hopefully not beyond reason. Go to them. Convince the remaining clerics you are no demon to be feared. They have heard only frightful tales of you. Give them something else to believe.
That won't just make it worse?
Because you are Kunari?
Some people find me frightening.
Let me put it this way. You needn't convince them all. You just need some of them to doubt. The power is the unified voice. Take that from them and you receive the time you need.
So I show up, say hello, show them the mark on my hand.
I honestly don't know if you've been touched by fate, or sent to help us, but I hope. Hope is what we need now. The people will listen to your rallying call, as they will listen to no other. You could build the Inquisition into a force that will deliver us, or destroy us. I will go to Haven. And provide Sister Leliana the names of those in the Chantry who will be amenable to a gathering. It is not much, but I will do whatever I can.
Corporal Vale is coordinating the Inquisition's efforts in the area. We should speak with him.
Somebody, my wife needs help.
What's wrong with your wife?
She gets sick when the weather's foul. Can't catch her breath like cobwebs in her lungs. Our son Hindle makes a potion that lets her breathe. He's the only one who can make it, but he's joined that cult in the hills. Please, get to him and tell him what's wrong. Without that potion, she'll die.
Is there anything we can do to help people deal with the cold?
I asked the Inquisition to send blankets. You'd think I was asking for a wagon of raw Lyrian. A recruit named Whittle is trying to make what we can bring in last. If you have any ideas, talk to him across the road.
What can you tell me about the man who's supposed to be getting horses for the Inquisition?
Horsemaster Dennett. He lives on a farm to the west. Tough old fella. We haven't heard from him. Best we can tell, he's holed up until the Mages and Templars are done killing each other.
What other problems do these refugees face?
We've got some injuries that go beyond stitches and elf fruit. I know healers are in short supply, but if you can find someone in Redcliffe to help us, it would save a lot of lives.
What can you tell me about the Templars?
All the Templars were called to Val Royeaux not long ago. These bastards ignored the order. Now they're killing rebel mages, along with any refugees they think are mage sympathizers. Every Templar I've ever known has wanted to protect the common folk. These men defile their order's good name.
You were concerned about refugees starving?
Yes. Many of them brought food, but they expected to be home by now, or safe in a city. There's a hunter up the hill who has some ideas.
What can you tell me about the rebel mages?
The real rebels are up north in Redcliffe, dug in and taking care of their own. The ones out here are just apostates, locked up in the circles all these years, and now they've gone mad with power. The rebels in Redcliffe have washed their hands of them. I wish we could do the same.
Farewell.
And you as well.
That tower is impressive, even as a ruin. I wonder what dreams it might hold. Such an irresponsible use of magic. The mages here are little more than animals.
Could make camp here.
Nothing to report, sir.
This might interest you, sir.
What is it?
Templars. Looks like Carda.
With both Templars and mages here, they'd profit greatly from smuggling Lyria.
Nothing to report, sir.
Illuminates certain objects in the distance. I am not familiar with such magic.
Of course, it had to be a skull that lights up creepy shit.
Shouldn't we travel to Val-Royo now, Seeker? The breach isn't going to close itself.
Indeed.
The sooner we obtain help for the breach, the better. must have been some time since the renegade Templars faced a mage of any talent. Your abilities are remarkable, Seeker. It is fascinating to see how you and the Templars negate magic.
Have you never encountered Templars before?
Only at a distance. I am an apostate, after all.
And they never caught up with you even once.
I am a very careful apostate.
Our bastards killed my husband and stole the ring from his finger. They deserve to die.
You're saying the Templars attacked your husband?
Aye. He was digging out a stump. The fools couldn't tell a shovel from a mage's staff. Had to be safe, they said. Rebels everywhere, attacking by surprise, sick bastards. They took the ring I gave him on our wedding day in case it was magic.
Farewell.
Interesting. I cannot say what it is, but there must be a reason the skull illuminated the object.
Inquisition could maybe find out what these things are.
When they're ready, piss off.
Your kind killed the most holy.
Lies. Your kind let her die.
Shut your mouth, mage!
Enough!
Knight Captain!
That is not my title. We are not Templars any longer. We are all part of the Inquisition.
And what does that mean, exactly?
Back already, Chancellor. Haven't you done enough?
I'm curious, Commander, as to how your Inquisition and its Herald will restore order as you've promised.
Of course you are.
Back to your duties, all of you.
Mages and Templars were already at war. Now they're blaming each other for the Divine's death.
Which is why we require a proper authority to guide them back to order.
Who? You? Random clerics who weren't important enough to be at the Conclave.
The Rebel Inquisition and its so-called Herald of Andraste? I think not.
So far, you're the only one who's insisted we can't work together.
We might, if your Inquisition would recognize the Chantra's authority.
There is no authority until another divine is chosen.
In due time, Andraste will be our guide, not some dazed wanderer on a mountainside.
I'll make sure they see reason in Val Rayo.
I pray you're right.
For she who trusts in the Maker, fire is her water.
Apothecary Adon will have more pulses for the injured as soon as possible, revered mother.
How fares your quest to seal the breach?
Doing everything within my power.
A task such as closing the breach is a heavy burden. I hope you do not carry it alone. We remember Andraste, but Andraste did not carry the Chant of Light alone. She had generals, advisors, even her husband for a time. Do everything within your power, but remember those who would help you.
I appreciate your insight, Mother Giselle.
Take it for whatever it is worth. You walk a difficult path, and there is little enough I can do to aid you. In any case, I pray this Inquisition proves less brutal than its predecessor.
How are the people doing after what happened at the Conclave?
They are scared, of course. Many have lost homes or loved ones. I doubt many will sleep well until you have sealed the breach. I've offered what help I can. The rest is for the Inquisition. What more do you wish to know?
What are you doing to help these people?
My sisters and I have been tending to the injured as best we are able. Some refugees come with food, while others arrive empty-handed. I have helped ensure that all have enough to eat. Beyond that, many simply wish the familiar comfort of the Chant of Light. It is little enough work to offer some comfort to those in pain.
How are the villagers in Haven doing?
They are terrified. Many of them came here because the war between the Mages and the Templars destroyed their homes. In their minds, the death of a Divine has destroyed any chance of peace. To that, add the breach. Farmers have fled their fields. If we do not restore order, half of Thedas may starve.
Do you have information on people elsewhere?
The refugees in the hinterlands are desperate. Without help, starvation or war will claim many lives. Villagers in Crestwood are besieged by their own dead. They have sent word begging for assistance. People are vanishing in the hills of Emprise de Lyon. It may be demons or something worse, but they are terrified. More than that, I cannot say. It is a chaotic time for all in Olay and Ferelden.
Farewell.
Make her go with you.
Thank you.
Having the Herald address the clerics is not a terrible idea.
You can't be serious.
Mother Giselle isn't wrong. At the moment, the Chantry's only strength is that they are united in opinion.
And we should ignore the danger to the Herald.
Let's ask him.
What can they do? It's just talk.
Don't underestimate the power of their words. An angry mob will do you in just as quickly as a blade.
I will go with him. Mother Giselle said she could provide us names. Use them.
But why? This is nothing but a...
What choice do we have, Liliana? Right now we can't approach anyone for help with the breach. Use what influence we have to call the clerics together. Once they are ready, we will see this through. The city still mourns.
Just a guess, Seeker, but I think they all know who we are.
Your skills of observation never fail to impress me, Varric.
My Lord Herald!
You're one of Leliana's people. What have you found?
The Chantry Mothers await you, but so do a great many Templars.
There are Templars here?
People seem to think the Templars will protect them from the Inquisition. They're gathering on the other side of the market. I think that's where the Templars intend to meet you.
Only one thing to do, then.
They wish to protect the people? From us?
You think the Order's returned to the fold, maybe? To deal with us upstarts?
I know Lord Seeker Lucius. I can't imagine him coming to the Chantry's defense. Not after all that's occurred. Return to Haven. Someone will need to inform them. Return to Haven. Someone will need to inform them if we are... delayed.
As you say, my lady.
Return to Haven. Someone will need to inform them if we are... delayed.
As you say, my lady.
Return to Haven. Someone will need to inform them if we are... delayed.
As you say, my lady.